myself Nitu Kumari and the bio teacher, and this is the chapter of class 9, chapter 7. This is the name of the chapter is plant diversity and animal diversity. In this chapter we will learn detail of kingdom Animalia. In the last video we had learned the detail of kingdom Plantae. In this video we have learned Animalia. So let's see, in these are eukaryotes, it means eukaryotics. They are multicellular and the heterotrophic, it means they can survive their body in heterotrophic surroundings, just like hot, warm, and in the region of their body is situated. They are further classified as non-chordate, just like the non-chordate. Some phylums are involved in this. These are Podifera, Coelenterata, Platyhelminthes, Nematode, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata. There are these seven kingdoms are involved in this Chordata phylum. And chordate, protochordate, vertebrate, biceps, amphibians, reptiles, apes, and mammalia. These are also the phylum is related to Animalia, and we have to learn about this. First, non-chordate. Non-chordate are those who have not a backbone, and they are can't standing, and they can't flow their body to a standing position. First, Podifera. Podifera is just like a spongy. The word Podifera means organism with hole. This is the important word. Podifera is this hole. The canal system is circulating. Circulating it means respiration, transportation of water, food, oxygen. They are non-motile with circular level and organism, and mainly muddy. They are muddy because their body is situated under the water. Organism with the hard water coat called skeleton. Hard water coat is skeleton. They are commonly called sponge. Example, Spongilla and Cycon. These are the two examples of Podifera. The next one is Coelenterata. Coelenterata. The word Coelenterata, it means organism with body cavity called coelenterium. They are readily symmetrical. Their body is symmetrical, it means glob-like. Diploblastic. Diploblastic, it means two layer of the cell. Two layer of the cell is present in their body. Commonly called as conidarians. Stinging cells for protection. Stinging cells are for the protect the body. They are present in the body. Example, Hydra, C. anemonia. C. anemonia and Hydra is the example of Coelenterata. And they have the important point is they have the two layer of the body cells to protect the body. Next one is Platyhelminthes. This word means organism means that warm dorsocylindrically flattened. Dorsocylindrically means two layer of the cells is flattened. Body is smooth and very flat. They are bilaterally symmetrical. Triploblastic layer. Triploblastic means the cell layer of the body is three. They are either free living or parasitic. Maybe free living or parasitic. No true coelom is present. You can feel that they have the coelom, but they have no coelom is present in the body. Example, Planaria. This is free living. Tapeworm. एग्जाम्पल ऑफ प्लेटी हेमन थ्री प्ले लिविंग इज प्लीमेरिया एंड टेप वॉर्म इज पैरासिटिक. टेप वॉर्म दिस इज प्रेजेंट इन ह्यूमन बॉडी इंटेस्टाइन. नेक्स्ट वन इज नेमाटोड. नेमाटोड इट मीन्स द ऑर्गेनिज्म इज राउंड वॉर्म. दे आर बायोलिटरली सिमेट्रिकल एंड रिप्लोब्लास्टिक. Already know that triploblastic it means three layer of the cell. Familiar with parasitic, they are also familiar parasitic worm. The first cilum is called pseudobilome. Example: Ascaris, Bucheria, Phalaria worm cause elephantiasis. Phalaria worm is Bucheria. Bucheria cause elephantiasis where our in the where this parasite is living in our body, the leg of human body is become elephantiasis. So fat of the body, our leg. Next one is Annelida. It means organism with metameric segment. Metameric means divided segment. They are bilaterally symmetrical, and the layer of the body is triploblastic. Familiar with cockroach. They cilum is body filled. Cilum is present in body blood filled called as hemocilum. Hemocilum. The example of Annelida is prawn, scorpion and housefly. Next one is mollusca. The word mollusca is organism with soft body. Mollusca represent the soft body. The body is symmetrical and also triploblastic. This is familiar with octopus. They have an open circulatory system, kidney-like organs for excretion. And the example is also this snail is the example of mollusca. Next one is Echinodermata. It means spiny mammals. They are free living and marine also. They are triploblastic. The three layer is present in the body. Their structure is made by hard layer of the calcium carbonate. Example: sea star and sea urchin. This is the example of Echinodermata. So one part of the detail of kingdom Annelida is completed. Next video we will learn about protochordata, vertebrae, fishes, amphibians, reptiles and mammalia. So thanks for this video.